Hey, hell is this, man? What's up, HighFlyGang? It's your boy, Birdy. Today, we have Machine Gun Kelly, Rap Devil, Eminem this. Now, before we get into this, I just need to say that I already know everything about beef. I heard the Rap Devil, I heard the kill shot, but last year I didn't have a YouTube channel. Since I have right now YouTube channel for rap reactions, I felt like I want to do a review, just to discuss some things about who do I think won and to discuss more about the beef. So, what I know about MGK, I heard him first time in 2011 when he dropped Wild Boy. I was still in high school, man. And from that day, I never stopped listening to him. I like his song. I know most of it. I have even MGK shirt. I literally appreciate the dude. But Eminem, I also like him. I grew up listening to Eminem, basically. I know most of his songs. I like both artists. I'm sorry for my talking. Sometimes I can bug. So, I won't be biased, man, because I like them both. I will just give my honest opinion on the final part. When I listen on the part 2, Kill Shot, I will give you my opinion. Let's proceed. Let's see. My headphones, man. World Star Hip Hop.
Oh my god, Ronnie.
Hey.
Ronnie. I don't know who's the guy, but he's probably a beat maker. He made the crazy beat. On this one, I like the beat more than the kill shot. He did an amazing job.
Somebody grab him some clippers. His fucking beard is weird. Tough talk from a rapper paying millions for security a year. I think my dad's gone crazy. Yeah, Haley, you right. Dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio, yelling at the mic. You so.
I mean, I watched reactions from other people also. This is what I would also say, man. When you mention Eminem's daughter, he will come as twice as hard on you as would he come on you in general. You don't mention his daughter, but I guess that's what MGK want. Come on, man, I'm mentioning your daughter. Give your best, I wanna see that. So, MGK is good, he is hardcore, man. He doesn't give a damn.
Bored, huh? I know. I'm about to be 46 years old, dog. Talking about I'm a cool up trick. Man, you sound like a bitch, man.
That line, I know because that's how the beef started, man. I think in 2012, MGK posted some tweet like, I just saw a picture of Eminem's daughter, and I think she's hot as you know what. I don't like us. And then Eminem didn't know for that. And then after that, he shot some subliminal disses on LA Leakers freestyle on the feature with Tech 9, and after that, Eminem basically many years later, he dissed him on Kamikaze with another like he said, better not call trick. I heard the song, that's what he's addressing right now about trick. Man, you sound like a beat.
Never handle your shit. Mad about something I said in 2012, took you 6 years and a surprise album just to come with a diss. Homie, we get it.
Yeah, I mean, he's spitting facts. It took 6 years just to come up with this. I don't know if he took 6 years, I don't think he paid any attention to it, but speaking as a song, it was a good line.
We know that you're the greatest rapper alive. Fucking dweeb, all you do is
this is the one thing I wouldn't recommend if you're doing this track, go completely dissing, man. He said, like, we know you're the greatest rapper alive. Like, in my opinion, by saying that, you're admitting, but I don't know, it's okay. Let's see.
Read the dictionary and stay inside. Fuck rap god, I'm the rap devil. Come a bare face with a black shovel like the Armageddon.
This is the good trick. I think it's a good marketing trick also, because you know Eminem made a rap god, so he's doing now a rap devil opposite. Like, I'm opposite of you, I'm your enemy, and we're gonna fight now. That is a good marketing trick, also, and a good idea for the diss.
And when the smoke settles, his body next to this instrumental, I'm saying, I'm sick of them sweats.
I like this one also. When the smoke settles, his body's next to this instrumental. I like that.
Dweeb, all you do is read the dictionary and stay inside. Fuck rap god, I'm the rap devil. Come a bare face with a black shovel like the Armageddon. When the smoke settle, his body next to this instrumental. I'm saying, sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. All of us single dads from the Midwest, we can talk about it.
I like the hook. Like he was trying not just to make a diss track, but also at the same time to make a hit song. Because since I'm dissing Eminem, let's make, next to the diss, let's make a hit song. Because he has a hook, he has a crazy beat, and his lines are good towards Eminem. I mean, Eminem is a legend, but he got some balls coming at him, and he's coming at him really, really good. I think, I don't know any rapper before him that come at him this good. The first time I heard this, I was stunned, man. I couldn't believe my eyes, my ears. Silly me again.
Oh, we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Let's talk about the fact you actually blackball a rapper that's twice as young as you. Let's call Sway, ask why I can't go up to Shape 45 because of you. Let's ask Interscope how you.
This one was good. I like this one especially. With Sway line. Let's hear it again.
Young as you talk. Let's call Sway, ask why I can't go up to Shape 45 because of you. Let's ask Interscope
like
how you had Paul Rosenberg trying to shelf me. Still can't cover up the fact your last 4 hours as bad as your selfie. Now tell me, what do you stand for?
What?
I know you can't stand yourself. Trying to be the old you so bad you stand yourself.
That one was really good when I heard it the first time. Trying to be old you, trying to be old you, you so bad you stand yourself, man. You stand yourself.
Let's leave all the beef in the 50.
Please.
M, you push a 50. Why you claiming I'm a call puff when...
That line with the age, I don't find any good parts of that guy. If you're 46 years old or you're pushing 50, I don't find anything good about that. But other than that, he had crazy bars.
You the one that called Diddy.
Facts.
Then you went and called Jimmy.
Facts.
The conference called me in the morning. They told me you mad about a tweet. You wanted me to say sorry. I swear to God, I ain't believe him. Please say it ain't so. The big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke.
That was a great line. I don't know if this really true or it's not. I don't know. But comment down below. Do you think it's true Eminem gave a call to Diddy? Or no, because he's saying you're the one that called Diddy. So comment down below. What do you think? Did he or did he not?
You want some fucking smoke, but not literally, you'll choke.
Ooh.
Yeah, like can't
this one was a great line.
Fucking joke. Oh, you want some fucking smoke, but not literally, you'll choke.
Oh, you want some effing smoke, but not literally, you'll choke. That was a good bar.
Dope. Yeah, I'll acknowledge you the GOAT, but I'm the gunner, bitch, I got you in the scope. Don't have a...
Yeah, acknowledge you the GOAT, but I'm a gunner, bitch, I got you in the scope. It's clearly he spent a lot of time working on it. He take this beef really serious, man. He knew who he was coming after. And...
Heart attack now. Somebody help your mans up.
Help.
Knees weak or old age. The real Slim Shady can't stand up. I'm sick of them sweat suits.
This one also good, the reference to real Slim Shady. Knees weak from old age, the real Slim Shady can't stand up. The knees weak, also from Lose Yourself, he put it together. MGK is good, man.
Some corny hats, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. All of us single dads from the Midwest, we can talk about.
That's one, yeah. All of the single dads for the Midwest, because Eminem is now a single dad, he's divorced. He's not married, he has a kid, and they're both for the Midwest. So I kinda, that was my favorite bar in the hook. All of both rappers for the Midwest, let's talk about it.
About it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it.
Put some white chalk around it. Come on, I'm...
Hello, Marshall. My name's Colson. You should go back to recovery. I know your ego is hurting just knowing that all the...
This line after line, I liked everyone. Every line I liked. Like, hello, Marshall. My name is Colson. You should go back to recovery. Like his old album from 2010. The years before he was a drug user.
Your fans damn. Discovered me. He like, damn, he a younger me. Except he dresses better and I'm...
Like, damn, he a younger me.
Muggly, always making fun of me. Stop all the thuggery, Marshall, you living in luxury. Hey, look what you've done to me. Dropped an album just because of me. Damn, you in love with me. You got money, but I'm hungry. I like it this, but you won't say them lyrics out in front.
That sounded super hot. This also, I liked this part also, but... I don't know, man. It was good. You said... He dropped album just because of me. I don't know if he really did. He dissed many people on Kamikaze, but it was a good line, man.
Me. Shout out to every rapper that's up under me. Know that I'll never do you like this fuckery. Still bitter after everyone loves you. Pull that wedgie out your dungarees. I gotta respect the OGs, and I know most of them personally. But you just a bully acting like a baby, so I gotta read you a nursery.
That one was good. Let's hear it again.
Most of them personally. But you just a bully acting like a baby, so I gotta read you a nursery.
Yeah.
For the future, and you just Ebenezer Scrooge. I said I'm flex, anyone can get it. I know it will be you. I'm sick of them.
I said on flex and anyone could get it. I know it would be you on the flex freestyles. Yeah, man.
Suits some corny hats, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. All of us single dads from the Midwest, we can talk about it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Hey, ride a shoddy cause I got a road, it's dope. It's a fast road when your idols become your rivals.
That was what I strictly noticed when I listened to this. When your idols become your rivals. Before he was my idol, I grew up to listening to this guy, man. And now I'm here and he's my rival, I'm sorry. That means I made something on myself. I'm doing something good for myself. Somebody who was my idol, now it's my rival, man. You gotta respect the hustle this man did.
Yeah. Never hesitate to say it to your face. I'm an asshole.
Oh my bitch ass motherfucker.
We know you get nervous, rabbit. I see mama spaghetti all over your sweater.
That was the sickest part in the song. The very first beginning of this verse. We know you get nervous, rabbit. I see mama spaghetti all over your sweater. Like the reference of Lose Yourself, he's taking to diss him.
I wish you would lose yourself in the records that you made a decade ago. They were better. According to them, you're a national treasure.
National treasure. Oh, man.
To me, you're soft as a feather.
To me, you're soft as a feather. He just dissing after line after line. All the good bars. All.
To be scared to ask Rihanna for a number. Just hold her umbrella, Ella, Ella.
Just call her umbrella, Ella, Ella. Like her hit song.
I'm not afraid. Okay, Oscar the Grouch, chill on the couch. You got an Oscar, damn. Can anyone else get some food in their mouth? For real, they made a movie about you.
Can any of us get food in their mouth? Yeah, man. But you gotta fight for your place in the rap game. Come on, man. You gotta push it.
You and everybody's top 10. You're not getting better with time, it's fine. Eminem, put down a pen. Or write an apology. Or with a simple fact, you had a diss to acknowledge me. I am the prodigy, how could I even look up to you? You ain't as tall as me. 5'8", man, I'm 6'4". 7 punches, hold your head still.
That's one thing I also noticed. MGK's tall as shit, man. 5'8", man, I'm 6'4". You ain't tall as me. How can I look up to you? You ain't as tall as me. That was the sick line too. 5'8", man, I'm 6'4". How can I look up to you, mate?
Last time you saw 8 Mile was at home on a treadmill.
On the thing you're running, on the treadmill. Last time you saw 8 Mile was on a treadmill. I ran 8 Mile. That was a sick line too.
Named after a candy. I was named after a gangster. And don't be a sucker and take my verse off
I was named after a candy, like he told at Eminem's. I was named after again. There was some gangster, Machine Gun Kelly, that he took name from. Okay.
Yellow Wolf's album, thank you. I just wanna feed my daughter, you try to stop the money.
Also, what do you think? Did Eminem really took off his verse from Yellow Wolf's album? Comment down below. Or did he not? Because that's his side of story. Maybe speaking some truth, maybe he's something lying, I don't know. But as the bars are great. Looking for the point of bars, he's killing it. But comment down below if you think he lied about something or not.
The supporter, you don't want to always talk about the action. Text me the Addy, I'm pulling up scrapping.
Oh, that was hardcore. Text me the Addy, man, I'm pulling up scrapping. I'm not playing, man. Just text me the address. Where do you live, man? That was great, too.
I'm by my fucking self, what's happening? EST captain, salute me and shoot me. That's what he's gonna have to do to me when he realizes that it ain't shit he can do to me. Everybody always hated me. This isn't anything new to me. Yeah, there's a difference between us. I got all of my shit without Dre producing me. I know you're not.
That was sick too. I remember that when I listened to the song before. Yeah, there is a difference between us. I got all of my shit without Dre producing me. We all know Dr. Dre is one of the biggest rap producers of all time, man. So he made a great bar out of that. Yeah, there is a difference between us. I got all of my shit without Dre producing me. Like, if Dre make beat for me, I will be a lot more success too. But maybe he wouldn't. Who knows?
Anything new to me. Yeah, there's a difference between us. I got all of my shit without Dre producing me. I know you're not used to me. Usually one of your disses should ruin me. My bitch up, I'm cleaving, everybody quiet this evening. I'm reading a eulogy. Drop an album called Kamikaze, so that means it kill him.
Ali, drop album Kamikaze, so that means it kill him. Like in Japan with the Kamikaze, they sacrifice themselves to kill other person.
Alright, he fucked one rapper's girl this week, don't make me call Kim. I'm
sick. And that was when my face was stunned. I just fucked another rapper's girlfriend, don't make me call Kim. Like that other rapper was probably Jeezy with a whole thing that was going on also at the time.
Get them sweatsuits, some corny hats, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. Bob of a single dad's from the Midwest, we can talk about it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it.
Man, it was a crazy song. Like I said, I listened to it before a couple of times. I know Rap Devil, this is just a review. This track was great. This was the, I think he did in the best possible way he could do to come at Eminem. I won't discuss now who I think won or who was better. I will do that in part 2 when I do a reaction to Killshot. So, that will be it for today. See you in the part 2 on the Killshot. If you want to become a part of a HighFlyGang gang, make sure you like, share and subscribe. Peace out.
Okay, man.
Motion.